The great Imam of the Sahaba, the youngsters of the Sahaba, Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Hisham, he enters upon the great woman, radiallahu anha, Sayyidina Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha, and he asks a hadith in Sahih Muslim. He wants to ask about the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if we understand that the most important thing for you to understand is character, the most important thing for you to attain is character, from a perspective, there is no question other than the question of character. You get the point? And so Sahl ibn Hisham radiallahu ta'ala anhu wadda, he's asking Aisha that sort of golden question. Kayfa kana khuluq Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How was the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Ala taqra'u al-Qur'an? Ama taqra'u al-Qur'an? Do you not read the Qur'an? And Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha wadda, in a language here, it's what's called ta'arid here in Lughat al-Arab. She's saying in a very gentle and polite way in order to ensure that Sayyidina Sahl ibn Hisham radiallahu anhu wadda understands the answer of Aisha. Bala, of course I recite the Quran, he says. Kana khuluqu al-Quran. She says his character was the Quran. Meaning in accordance to your knowledge of the Quran, is going to be, and proportional to that is your knowledge of the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And the meaning is in the end of the hadith, which Imam Ghazali doesn't bring, that Sa'd bin Hisham radiallahu anhu warda, he said, I stood up and thereby I resolved never to ask a question ever again. Hakada, because the entire answer is that. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, أَقْرَبِ إِلَيَّ مَجْلِسًا يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَ أَحَسَنُكُمْ خُلُقًا, that the closest of you to me upon the day of judgment are those of you in the best of character, then if it is about proximity to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is, then it's all about character. If it's about you, your understanding of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the Mizan, Bilqist, Mawazin Bilqist, that when the actual scales are erected in justice, and it's about how weighty your deeds are upon the day of judgment, Amam Allah, in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then likewise in Tirmidhi, the Prophet sallallahu Afqalu shay al Mizan, he said the most heaviest, weightiest thing upon the scales, Yawm al-Qiyamah, Husnul Khuluq, good character, husnul khuluq. As a husnul khuluq, kulla shay. It is everything. And that's why the Imams radiallahu anhum wardahum and the greatest of them, Al-Ghazali rahimahullah ta'ala, have been preoccupied with the reality, the topic of husnul khuluq in and of itself. وَإِنَّمَا أَدَّبُهُ الْقُرَانَ بِمِثْلِ قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى. So Imam Al-Ghazali rahimahullah ta'ala herein, he wants to give examples of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam through the Qur'an. And what's important about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is Qur'ani in nature. So you can find the traditions, like tradition of Aisha, about the inward. Remember, khuluq is inward of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam be Qur'ani. You can find the traditions of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu about the khalq, qita' al-mus'haf. He says it's a piece of the mus'haf, Abu Hurairah, the khalq of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So whether you're looking at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam physically, or you're observing him sallallahu alaihi wasallam spiritually, you are observing the Qur'an. Okay? Remember, when we speak about the ayat of Allah Ta'ala, the Qur'an is ayat. The Imams radiallahu anhum wardahum, they divide the ayat, Qur'an, ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into two types of ayat. Ayat, what we translate as verses, more strictly translated as signs. They say ayat al-mandhura wa ayat al-mastura. There are two types. Ayat al-mandhura, there are signs of Allah Ta'ala. Let's take verses of Allah Ta'ala that you witness, that are seen, whether with the physical eye, whether with the spiritual eye. And there are ayat al-mastura, then there are verses of Allah Ta'ala that are written. You see, many of us, when we speak about the Qur'an, we're speaking about the Qur'an as mastura, a written book. But there is a Qur'an that is mandhura. There's a Qur'an that is witnessed, that is observed. And the Qur'an that is witnessed and observed is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Very, very important. By and large, remember, fi ahdi Rasulillah, up until the last moment of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no Qur'an al-mastura. There is no Qur'an in a physical book. None up until the day the Prophet doesn't go to the barzakh. Sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And so where then do the Sahaba read the Qur'an from? Mandhura. From Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And that is very, very important, that the religion of Allah Ta'ala that comes through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a living, organic religion. It is inextricably bound to human beings and how they behave in an exemplary manner. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ brings. Remember the title that Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah ta'ala brings, Akhlaq al-Nubuwa. Akhlaq al-Nubuwa. Imam al-Zuhri, some of our sisters were blessed to hear the name Zuhri today, radiallahu anhu warda. He said, Zuhri, he said, when it relates to revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not revelation that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it's written down in books. But it's revelation that comes from Allah ta'ala to the prophets and it impacts the prophets and then they manifest it in their behavior, in their character, in how they walk. Like Aisha in another riwayah, she says, كَانَ الْقُرْآنِ يَمْشِي بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. He was a Qur'an that walked amongst people. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Very, very important. It relates like Ustad Nisar of one of the questions that he asked previously, that the nature of Nubuwa, it is how a human being walks amongst others. It's not found in books, yani. And if you're strictly speaking about Nubuwa, it's not even found in words. The prophets are the most silent of all human beings. The most silent. Anyone who studies Tawheed understands that. The prophets don't speak. The prophets don't even tell you to follow them, yani. They just act. And on the basis of the profundity of their action, human beings are attracted to the prophets in and of themselves. Beautifully, outwardly and inwardly. مَا أَرْسَلَ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا قَطْ إِلَّا حَسَّانُ الْوُجُوهُ. هَكَدَ سَيْنَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ بِنْ عَبَّاسَ said that Allah Ta'ala has never sent a prophet ever illa hassanul wujuh. Say that outwardly he is beautiful and his outward reflects his inward. The prophets, but the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallama, shay'an akhar, is something completely different than the rest of the corpus of the prophets sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallama. How blessed the sahaba were radiallahu anhum warda'am to take religion literally from him sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam embodied the word of his Lord. Yeah, Imam al-Suhrawardi rahimahullah ta'ala, of the really great Imams radiallahu anhu warda of tradition, Imam al-Suhrawardi has a really famous book, A'warif al-Ma'arif radiallahu anhu, usually in the old versions, if anybody bought an old version, it's like a newer version, anybody bought an older version of Ihya al-Umuddin, you buy it in 4 or 5 volumes, the older sort of versions, Arabic versions, in what's called the Hawashi, in the margins of Ihya al-Umuddin, they would always place Suhrawardi's book, Rahimullah ta'ala, Al-A'rif wal-Ma'arif, radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. Therein he makes mention, radiallahu anhu warda, that Sayyidina Aisha, Hakkad, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ashuf, you come in to ask, and you are Sahaba, yani, but he's young from the Sahaba. You come in to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let me say, Aisha, how was the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Then there's a quote unquote, there's a degree of deficiency in your understanding of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, isn't it? Because you're asking the question. And so, As-Suhrawardi rahimahullah ta'ala said that Aisha radiallahu anha wardaha in a brilliance that she's going to answer the question in accordance to the questioner. You understand it? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Nazzil an-nas manazilahum." Treat people accordingly. "Khatib an-nas ala qadri uqulihim." Speak to people in accordance to their mindset, to where they are. He said the real statement Aisha wants to make is that the character of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the character of God. He says, radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. But if you're struggling to understand his character, then you can't understand that type of lofty and refined statement. Suhrawardi says, because what does the character of the Quran mean? Like, what is the Quran? An abstract book? Is that how we understand the Quran? Or is the Quran sifatullah? Is it an attribute of God? What is the Quran? Kalam Allah. The great woman herself, radiallahu anha wardaha, Aisha, this is a defate. There's two covers. She says, "Ma bayna daf'atay al-mushaf." She says, what is between the two covers of the mushaf? Kalamullah is this pre-eternal speech of God. And so when we're saying that the Prophet's character is the Quran, then his character, huwa alladhi takhallaqa bi akhlaq ar-Rahman. Hakada Suhrawardi says literally that he is the one who embodied the akhlaq, the character, the nature of the Rahman Jalla Jalalu wa Ta'ala Ta'azamatu. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for tawfiq, inshallah, tabarakallah.